If you have your Bibles, let's all stand in the reading of the Word of God, if you would please. Psalms 31, and we'll start with verse 1. Psalms 31 and verse 1. Say amen when you found me. That was a little weak. Psalms 31 and verse 1. Say amen when you found me. In thee, O Lord, do I put my trust. Let me never be ashamed. Deliver me in thy righteousness. Bow down thy ear to me. Deliver me speedily. In Hebrew word, that means, amen, Lord, please hurry up. Be thou my strong rock, for my house of defense to save me. Thou art my rock and my fortress, therefore thy name's sake, lead me and guide me. Pull me out of the net that they have laid privately for me, for thou art my strength. Into thy hand I have committed my spirit. Thou hast redeemed me, O Lord God of truth. I have hated them that regard lying and vanities, but I trust in thee. I will be glad and rejoice in thy mercy, for thou hast considered my trouble. Thou hast known my soul and adversities, and have not shut me up into the hand of the enemy. Thou hast set my feet in a large room. Have mercy upon me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. My eyes is consumed with grief, yea, my soul and my belly. For my life is spent with grief, and my years with sighing. My strength faileth because of my iniquities. My iniquity and my bones are consumed. Let's pray. Our precious Heavenly Father, we come to you. Lord, anoint me to bring forth thy word and rightly divide the word of truth. Help me, Lord Jesus. Lord, give us ears to hear, not only to hear, but to understand. And we ask it all in Jesus' name. And the church says, amen. Amen. You may be seated if you can. God, give us strength in these perilous times. If I put a title on the message, amen. God, give us strength in these perilous times. We need His strength. It don't come from us. It comes from Him to give us strength. I believe it's in Psalms 19, verse 31. Chapter 31 and verse 19. Oh, how great is thy goodness which I have laid up for them that fear thee, which I have wrought for them that trust in thee because the sons of men. Thou shalt hide them in the secret of thy presence from the pride of men. Thou shalt keep them secretly in a pavilion from the strife of tongue. When the world seems to be shaken, there will arise a people, amen, who knows how to maintain their strength in the midst of it all. These are people who draw near to the Lord in times of crisis. We won't bellow down, we won't hide. We won't keep silence, but we'll get up and fight a good fight of faith and lay hold on eternal truth. Did you hear me? God didn't give us a spirit of fear, but of love and power and a sound mind. According to the scriptures, amen, it won't matter to these people if the moon and the stars are falling from the sky, or if the mountains quake, amen, and fall into the sea. They will still have faith unto this, amen, in the Lord to save them, and they will not have their faith shaken by anything that comes. Amen. Man, we can tell whose faith has been shaken, yes, and who's remaining strong, yes, in these troublesome times. Yes. You'd be amazed. Oh, I surely was. Psalms 31 and 19 and 20, David is telling us, amen, all true strength comes from drawing near to the Lord. Indeed, the measure of our strength is our nearness to Him. How close are you to the Lord? All these troubles and news we hear on, we see, and amen, just people going crazy. Amen, the far left, and amen, Seattle, Washington, they got several blocks blocked off, called it their own stuff. Somebody got killed in there the other day, another one wounded. Amen, glory to God. Amen, and they march out on the streets. Amen, they have no mask. They ain't practicing social distancing. But you don't hear the news media saying anything about that. Did you hear me? The Lord be quiet on me.
Amen.
I don't care if you're a Democrat or Republican. It don't make no difference. I'm here to tell you that we got to stand strong and draw near to the Lord.
Amen.
Church, shut your mouths long enough. That's the reason. We got abortion clinics, and we're going to stand accountable for all these leaders we put in office. Amen. They're saying that, amen, it's all right to abort the babies. Now they're saying after it's born, you can kill it. Amen. We sound like and look like a third world nation. Barbaric. Amen. Kill a baby after it's born. Just make sure it's comfortable, and it's all right. It's up to the doctor and the mother if the baby still lives. I'm here to tell you there's going to be a price that America is going to have to pay. Amen. And the church to keep its mouth shut. But we ought to get out and say, hey, enough is enough. Ooh, be quiet. Be quiet. The closer we are to Jesus, the stronger we're going to be. In fact, all the strength we're ever going to need will come through our secret life of prayer. He showed us through these calamities how strong the church is. We look through the calamities and people begin to speak and begin to murmur. Oh, my goodness. I don't care if you lock yourself in the house. I don't care if you hide yourself in the basement. Amen. If it comes your way, it'll come your way. I'm here to tell you, let's stand strong in the power of His might, because you can't hide from nothing like this. Only thing I can remember in the Word of God that, amen, when the death angel came through the land of Egypt, they said, amen, he should take the blood, amen, of the ghost and put it over the doorpost. And he said, when I see the blood, I will pass. I will pass over you. You think the goat, the blood of a goat is more powerful than the blood of Jesus applied to our hearts and our lives? Amen. Believe it or not, take God in His word. Did you hear me? Like I told somebody, I ain't going out looking for it, but I ain't staying home. Cowering down in fear. Did you hear me? In these troubled times, the church needs to remain strong and be true to God. Did you hear me? The glory of God, if there's ever time we're going to trust Him, we better trust Him now. If we're ever going to trust Him, it's now. We got to trust Him and believe in Him. Amen. The reason why the church is silent on abortions. I heard a black lady on Fox News and had a couple others that was for it. And this one black lady said, amen. She said, I serve the Lord Jesus Christ. When I will never say it's all right to kill the unborn. Amen. It never has and it never will be in the sight of God. She said, I'm a Christian and ain't no way I would vote or agree on anything like that. Did you hear me? Church, if we ever could take a stand. Amen. Lord of God, people try to intimidate you, try to be louder than you. That Lord of God, wait, they got to get their breath in a few minutes. And while they're doing that, then you can tell them your part. He will draw near to us. And by drawing near to Him, we will be given a fresh supply of strength daily. But it's a time that we can see, amen, that we are in His presence. Amen, you can't get it from the TV preachers. You can't get it from a book. Amen, the only book you will get it from is going to be the Holy Word of God, nothing else. To get into our prayer clothes and draw strength from Him to help us stand in these troublesome times. Did you hear me? The devil greatly fears the Lord's presence in our lives. Let me say it one more time. The devil greatly fears the Lord's presence in our lives. He trembles at the very thought of a believer's nearness to Jesus. So when the demonic hordes see you breathing out prayer and drawing near to the, amen, presence of your Heavenly Father, all hell will take note. Did you hear me?
Amen.
We think we're going to get it from our government. No, it is not. Our help comes from the Lord. Did you hear me? Our help comes from Him. Amen. No matter if you're a libertarian, a Democrat, or Republican, independent, whatever you might claim yourself to be, I'm a child of God foremost in anything. And I am not ashamed of the gospel, because it is power to salvation to them that believe and call on Jesus. Church, to the Lord. How quickly can you? This reason, Satan will do everything in his power to rob you of the Lord's presence. It is why he makes so many attempts to bog down your soul with worries about the future. Brother Floyd, I've got children and grandchildren. Steal it while they're young. Amen. And tell them, amen, the way you're going to make it in this life is to have Jesus in your heart, in your life. You can't cuss, do drugs, amen, go to God, lay around and think it's all right. And God's up, I'm saved. Everybody you talk to, I'm saved. Amen, I'm here to tell you, if you're saved, you can get in the house of God. If you're saved, people say they're Paul of Christ, but curse everywhere. Use bad language. Sing in a choir of the local churches. You say, well, brother, put that preacher. You can't blame the preacher. You don't know if that preacher might be preaching heaven sweet and hell hot. They're just not listening. One more time. For this reason, Satan will do everything in his power to rob you of the Lord's presence. It is why he makes so many attempts to bog down your soul with worries about the future. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, yes, you have a reason to worry.
Amen.
You would have to be totally blind not to see judgment that is now coming upon America and upon the world. The enemy of your soul wants you to drain all your strength. So he will use anything he can, even good things, to keep you away from spending time alone with Jesus. He knows your time with Christ enables you to endure fear and anxieties, even this worrisome time that we are in. Lord, give me strength. We pray, give me strength, but we've got to do. can't see where this is heading to. Down life's road about the churches. They're using this pandemic to keep the churches closed and keep everybody separated. He knows your time with Christ, the enemy. Enables you to endure fear and anxiety even in this worst of time. The whole world is aware we are facing a very difficult time as never before in history have we seen the time we're living in. As believers, we each are faced with an important question. How near am I to Jesus in this hour? How near am I to Jesus in this hour? If you want to be able to stand fast in the storm, the scriptures, amen, counsels, it's simple. You must have the Lord's presence in your lives, your life daily. How much quality time do you spend alone with Jesus? Are you drawing closer to Him with each passing day? Do you pray without ceasing? That is, to silently call out to Him throughout the day and evening. He promised to hear your cry, even when we utter in weakness. If you don't draw, on His strength, your heart will faint. Your words will have little, no power or result. Your testimony will be lifeless. Why? Because you will have drifted away from your source of strength. Don't make the mistake of measuring your walk with Christ by your good works or ministry rather than by His presence in your life. Paul faced many hard, perilous times. This godly man knew what it meant to a man to have everything to be. Amen. Hungry, thirsty, to suffer, to be in poverty, but be abandoned, to lie chained in a dark, dumb prison cell, alone and forsaken, even by some of his own closest friends. Paul did not faint. In fact, the apostle grew stronger through each trial. Paul knew the secret to getting and maintaining true strength. I believe it's 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 16 through 18. At my first answer, no man stood with me, but all men forsook me. I pray God that it may be, that may not be laid to their charge. Notwithstanding, the Lord stood with me and strengthened me, that by me the preaching might be fully known, and that all the Gentiles might hear. And I was delivered out of the mouth of the lion. And the Lord shall deliver me from every evil work, and will preserve me into His heavenly kingdom, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. They didn't have what we have today. We got the written word of God in a book, in a Bible. Back then they had the scrolls of Isaiah and Daniel and so forth. Amen. Glory to God. They didn't have a church on every block you could go to and hear the blessed hope of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Why is the church that we're so weak and amen and frayed? Why is it that, glory to God, that our strength ain't like it? Amen, Paul. Paul went through shipwrecks, hungry and thirsty, beat. Amen. They didn't have prisons back then. If you do a little research on Paul and Silas, were stoned in jail, they threw them after being beaten, lacerations, and their cuts were open. They're in the dark, the bottom of the prison where the sewer went through, chained against the wall.
Amen.
And we can't take a little persecution.
Strong in the power of
Sometimes I don't think we realize we're all going to die one day.
Amen.
Young, old, babies, we're all going to die one day. And I'm here to ask you this morning, when that time comes, don't wait till you lay it on the flat of your back and say, God, oh, I'll do this and I'll do that. Do it while you've got good health. Do it while you've got your right mind. Do what you can for the kingdom of God. Don't wait. If something bad happens.
Right.
You said, Pastor, I'm a good old person. I don't bother nobody. I don't hurt nobody. Just being good don't get you to heaven.
Amen.
Did you hear me? Somebody told me, said, preacher, I don't cuss, I don't do this, I don't do that, and you telling me I ain't gonna go to heaven. I said, well, number one, I said, have you repented of your sins and asked Jesus in your heart? No, I have not. I said, well, you're not gonna make it to heaven. Because he's the only door to heaven. There's not many ways. There's only one way, and that's through the blood of Jesus Christ. Did you hear me? Preachers have quit preaching on hell. They don't mention hell in the pulpits no more. Amen. Because they're afraid it's going to offend somebody.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sorry you're going to be offended this morning. Because hell is going to be mentioned. Don't play with your soul. You know that one. And every time you come to church and God's Spirit woos you, amen, draws you, even at your house, it ain't going to be in church or going down around you. You know when God's dealing with you and you keep pushing Him away.
Yes.
Because we want the life of living. And any life that we live outside of Jesus is a miserable life. But the life of Jesus, and when all hell's raging against us, we can still put a smile on our face and sing a song. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound, that saved an old wretch like me. Thank you, Jesus. If I had not had His strength this coming August, me 28 years been pastoring the church. Same address, 8136 First Oak Park Highway.
Amen, bro.
Well, Brother Robert Pete used to say, I had a young pastor. I'm still young, 55 ain't old. When we first came up here, I was 25 or 26, so, amen, I was young, and I went by so quick. You know what I'm talking about, when times go by quick.
Amen.
This morning, do you know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? When Jesus said, preach and taught on hell more than He did about heaven, to warn you and me not to go there. He said it's a place of wailing and gnashing of teeth.
Amen, brother.
There's no friends in hell. You're not going to have a party and meet each other. Say, you will be so engulfed in the fires of hell.
Amen.
Oh, my. And every time your mouth slips out a bad word, I hope it rings in your mind. Hell is hot. Hell is hot. God help us. It don't make no difference if you don't believe there's a hell. It don't make no difference. It's one there. It's one there. You're going to believe it one day, but it'll be too late. I said earlier, sir, I said earlier probably several months back, I said, there's no atheist in hell.
Amen.
Did you hear me? it all over the microphone. We'll see what kind of faith you have. Oh, glory. Ain't God good?
All the time.
All the time.
If you're here, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, John 10:10 says, the thief comes not but to kill, to steal, and destroy. But Jesus said, I come that you have life and have it more abundantly. If your name was called today, if your name is called today, would you go to heaven? Death is just the beginning.
Amen.
Death is just the beginning. When we cross over, that's eternity. That's eternity.
Amen.
Come on, honey, get a song ready. Are you ready to meet the Lord? Don't wait till you get sick and something happens. Don't wait till something tragic and you land in the hospital. Back in the 90s, I'm going to share this story, you heard me say it before. A man and his wife came to church and he was a truck driver and came out one Sunday and didn't see him. Then I got a phone call and said that, I think this time he was in Roanoke or he was in Louisville Hospital. Found out that he had cancer. What time? I cannot remember. But it was bad. He said, Brother Brooke, pray that God have mercy and heal my body and I'll be there. Well, says, I do it for everybody. I pray before I leave. Pray for them. Probably 2 or 3 weeks later, he came to church. God's touched me! Testified. Wonderful! See you again, preacher. I said, okay. Make a long story short. Never seen him, heard anything from him. About 2 or 3 years later, he was back in the hospital, and this time the cancer had come back aggressively. And sent word to me, Pastor Brooke, we need you to come to Lewisdale. Back then I worked at Patton's and so on. I left work and went straight up there. They said, you need to come now. I said, okay. Went up there and he was bald and he was saying, preacher, they said the cancer's come back aggressively. They only given me a short time to live. I told the Lord if he healed me, I'd get a van and I'd haul the people in. And I prayed with him. And he died the next day. God knows us. He knows us. If he was going to do that, he would have done it the first time that God had touched him. And extended his life. tragic happens.
Praise the Lord.
Who shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Confess with your mouth and believe in thy heart the Lord Jesus Christ. Work while you can. Amen. You might be the only one saved in your family. The others will come in. If you be faithful and true to God, He'll be faithful and true to you. You got to get your mind made up. And your foot on the rock. Make heaven my home. Let's all stand. Heavy, heavy.